Tuesday night, President Trump made his first address to a joint session of Congress, marking the first major speech we heard since the inauguration. While the speech did show a different side of Trump, one that stuck to the script and used optimism instead of random gloating and attacks on the media, it also continued to show the president's insistence on waging a unilateral war against undocumented immigrants. In his speech, Trump praised VOICE, this newly created office of the Department of Homeland Security, as a way to support victims of crime from unauthorized immigrants. However, this move simply serves as propaganda to sell the administration's aggressive and expensive measures to the public. Trump says that the media ignores victims of crimes committed by undocumented immigrants, but he expects us to ignore his overreaching actions to shame those that are looking for a better opportunity in our country. Under this new plan, the public will be given a weekly report detailing where alleged criminals are from and where they currently live. Of course, the administration is sure to highlight immigrants from Mexico in order to build a stronger case for Trump's wall and enforce sanctions if Mexico doesn't bow to his demands. The Department of Homeland Security's own documents say that they plan to punish foreign governments if they don't play along with Trump's deportation plans. The president's report will also include information as to why any detained non-citizen was released and where they were let go. This information will be used to embarrass so-called sanctuary cities because they refuse to buy into Trump's campaign. Many communities are relying on the labor of undocumented workers to do the jobs that many Americans would refuse to do. These communities will certainly suffer economic consequences from this smear campaign of the president's. President Trump made a point to present undocumented immigrants as violent criminals, all so he could better market his plans to the American people. So what types of crimes will the administration target in these sweeping reforms? Well, the DHS clearly spelled that out in writing. They now consider that simply being in this country as an undocumented immigrant is enough of a crime for them to target someone, not only for this propaganda campaign, but for deportation. To echo recent comments by Chuck Schumer and Lindsey Graham, if someone commits a crime in this country, we should punish them according to the law, regardless of their status as an immigrant. But countless studies have shown that the immigrant population, yes, even those that are here without visas or citizenship, they commit less crimes than the average American. It's increasingly clear that Donald Trump and his supporters seek to address immigration concerns through strong-arm tactics that are meant to intimidate non-citizens in our country and discourage those who are seeking a better life in the U.S. from coming here in the first place. Sure, we need to address our immigration issues. There are many things about our system that have failed. Both naturalized citizens and immigrants face all sorts of challenges. That failure has led to an increased tax burden and a border that isn't properly secured. That is a potential threat to our national security. But far too many well-meaning immigrants are facing inefficiencies and backlogs. Bureaucracy has made legal immigration unnecessarily difficult. These are real problems. And even Paul Ryan says that measures to improve immigration should be welcoming, not threatening. The president and his administration must realize that immigration is what built this beautiful country. And the spirit of those coming here to chase a dream is why America was already great.